Why all the fuss about food allergies? Food allergies are a global public health concern, and on occasion, they can lead to death. That is why many regulators across the world have published legislation, standards, or guidance documents on how to declare allergens on pre-packed foods. There are broadly three reasons why your food business must control allergens. One, to ensure regulatory compliance. Two, to drive food safety standard compliance. And thirdly, but most importantly, to protect consumers from harm and indirectly protect your brand's reputation. What are food allergies, intolerances, and celiac disease? Food allergies are an abnormal hypersensitivity reaction to otherwise harmless proteins in food. For example, peanut protein. An allergic individual's body perceives this protein as being foreign and responds to it via the immune system to essentially neutralize the allergenic protein. Allergic reactions can manifest in different ways, from skin, respiratory, and gastrointestinal reactions to systemic reactions like anaphylaxis. Symptoms are generally acute, meaning that they start soon after the an allergic individual ate, drank, or came into contact with the food they are allergic to. Food intolerances include a broad spectrum of reactions, but none of them are driven by the immune system. Intolerances are usually dose-dependent and can be divided into three main types based on their cause: enzymatic, pharmacological, or undefined. The most prominent example of an enzymatic food intolerance is lactose intolerance. It is when somebody cannot break down the milk sugar lactose due to a deficiency in the digestive enzyme lactase. A pharmacological food intolerance is a reaction to a pharmacologically active component, like for example histamine, which in severe cases can cause scromboid food poisoning. Other examples of food intolerances include reactions to additives such as sulfur dioxide or colorants. Food intolerance reactions are generally not life-threatening or acute. The problem, however, is that food allergies and intolerance symptoms can be very similar, making them difficult to diagnose and manage. Celiac disease, which should not be confused with gluten intolerance or wheat allergies, is a lifelong autoimmune systemic disorder triggered by gluten found in barley, rye, and wheat. Although symptoms are not immediately life-threatening, they may slowly worsen over time. The disorder causes the villi in the small intestine, which is responsible for nutrient absorption, to diminish, therefore leading to nutrient deficiencies, chronic diarrhea, abdominal distension, weight loss, and general failure to thrive. Prolonged exposure can also lead to an increased risk of developing various types of cancers. How do food allergies impact consumers? Currently, there is no cure for food allergies, intolerances, or celiac disease, and some evidence even suggests that food allergies may be on the increase. In the case of food allergies, it is well documented that even small amounts of allergenic protein can cause an allergic reaction, and that the severity of that reaction may be dose dependent. Because patients need to avoid the foods they are sensitive to, they or their caregivers need to carefully examine all food labels. Therefore, allergen information must be available to consumers at the point of sale. This gives them the best possible opportunity to make informed and safe purchasing choices. What is the impact on food businesses if allergens are not controlled? In the past decades, product recalls due to undeclared allergens have consistently topped the ranks in multiple countries. Often these recalls could have been avoided if appropriate, simple, and robust allergen management plans were in place. So, a lack of allergen control does not only lead to consumer reactions and potentially loss of life, but it can also lead to food recalls, which cost companies a lot of money, diminishes consumer trust, lead to brand damage, and ultimately it can lead to loss of sales. How many people suffer from food allergies? Proportionally, more children suffer from food allergies than adults. Many children outgrow their allergies, but for others, it will persist into adulthood. On the other hand, adults might develop allergies for the first time later in life. The exact prevalence of food allergies are unknown, but it's estimated to be between 2 and 10%. Prevalence differs from one geographical region to another and is influenced by factors such as dietary practices, flora, and even genetics. Although an individual can potentially react to any food that contains protein, 90% of food allergic individuals react to one or more of a common list of foods, often referred to as the Big Eight. These foods are recognized as major allergens by Codex and are cereal containing gluten, which is wheat, rye, barley, and oats and spelt, crustacean, egg, fish, peanut, soybeans, milk, and tree nuts. Multiple countries have also identified their own priority allergens. For example, in several countries, lupin, sesame seeds, mustard, celery, and buckwheat are relevant because allergies to these foods are prevalent. Thus, the takeaway message is, food allergies, intolerances, and celiac disease are distinctly different adverse food reactions, and robust allergen management is needed to protect consumers and food companies from harm. In episode 2, we'll discuss common allergen management controls you can introduce into your business.